So lots of points that we have to gather for pre and mains, but I would like to start with history first, because selfie points, two four aspects pe unhone dene, fir uske baad hum numbers se dekhenge, right? And if preconceiver wants, he can also come in from, right? Ali. Go on.
Yes, students, ek name aaya tha. Kya aaya tha? History ka ek name aaya tha. Philosopher ka. बसवाया बसवेश्वरा, ठीक है? ये बार बार उन्होंने नेम लिया है, इसके बारे में थोड़ा सा हम डिस्कस करेंगे, ओके? बसवेश्वरा जो है ये फाउंडर थे लिंगायत, हमारे एक सेक्ट है, ओके? इसको समझने के लिए हमें एंशिएंट इंडिया में जाना पड़ेगा, और मेरे को लगता है कि आपने एंशिएंट इंडिया करी हुई है,
कर्नाटका
में सेक्ट है, लिंगायत को बता दूंगा सर। स्टूडेंट्स, लाइक आपने हड़प्पन सिविलाइजेशन पढ़ा था, एंड हड़प्पन सिविलाइजेशन में आपको ये पता है कि जो हम वर्शिप कर रहे थे, ठीक है, तो फर्स्ट थिंग आपको ये क्लियर होना चाहिए कि टेंपल वगैरह हड़प्पन सिविलाइजेशन में हमें नहीं मिलते हैं। तो हम जो वर्शिप कर रहे थे उस टाइम पर मेन हम करते थे मदर गॉडेस, ठीक है, इसको हम जो है अभी भी कर रहे हैं। तो कॉन्टिन्यूएशन में भी जैसे हम पता कर लेते हैं, कॉन्टिन्यूएशन में भी चल रही है हड़प्पन सिविलाइजेशन, तो मदर गॉडेस को हम कर रहे हैं वहां पर वर्शिप, और साथ में हमें पता चलता है प्रोटो शिवा, क्लियर। अब प्रोटो शिवा हमें केवल नाम मिला प्रोटो शिवा, अब हमने अलग अलग तरीके से उसको इंटरप्रेट किया। कुछ हमारे स्टूडेंट बोलेंगे प्रोटो शिवा जो है ये रुद्रा है, ठीक है, या शिवा है, तो उनको इंटरप्रेट किया गया कि बाद में जो हमारे शिवा का जो एक फॉर्म आ रहा है तो यहाँ से स्टार्ट हो रहा है हड़प्पन सिविलाइजेशन से, क्लियर स्टूडेंट। धीरे धीरे ये जो है आप देखेंगे कि मदर गॉडेस वाला जो कॉन्सेप्ट था वो खत्म हो रहा था, और हम देखेंगे फिर आती है हमारी वैदिक एज। वैदिक एज में हम जो वर्शिप कर रहे हैं किस गॉड को कर रहे थे मेन, यस, तो वैदिक एज को आप टू पार्ट में पढ़ते हैं, अर्ली वैदिक एंड लेटर वैदिक। तो अर्ली वैदिक एज में आपने देखा कि वहां पर हम इंद्रा को सबसे ज्यादा वर्शिप करते हैं, और उनको बोला गया पुरंदर डिस्ट्रॉयर ऑफ फोर्स, क्लियर, डिस्ट्रॉयर ऑफ फोर्स। सेकंड फिर हमने देखा, सेकंड नंबर पर आते हैं अग्नि, और जिनके लिए आपका हिम्स दिए गए 200 हिम्स, ठीक है, यहाँ से चीजें चेंज हो रही है। और इसी टाइम पर लेटर वैदिक पीरियड आते आते हमें अब विष्णु एंड शिवा के बारे में पता चलेगा, क्लियर स्टूडेंट। तो प्रोटो शिवा को आपने थोड़ा सा कंटिन्यू किया, तो यहाँ से हमें अब शिवा के बारे में और क्लियर होने लगा। गुप्ता पीरियड आते आते हमारे टेंपल्स बनने लगे थे, और हमने वैष्णव के ऊपर बहुत ज्यादा फोकस किया, ओके, बट जो शैविज्म के बारे में हमें थोड़ी जानकारी यहाँ से कम होने लगी, और हमें मेन जो पता चलता है शैविज्म के बारे में तो स्टार्ट हुआ भक्ति मूवमेंट के टाइम पर, और वो स्टार्ट होता है आपका साउथ इंडिया से, जिनको हम बोलते हैं नैनार सेंट। आपने पढ़ाए नैनार एंड अलवार, दो टाइप के सेंट मिलते हैं हमें साउथ इंडिया में। जो नैनार सेंट थे वो क्या थे आपके, किसको वर्शिप करते थे, शिवा को, और जो अलवार है वो वैष्णव। तो 63 नैनार सेंट के बारे में हमें पता चलता है, ओके। यहाँ से हम थोड़ा सा और ग्रेजुअल आगे बढ़ते हैं, देन अब 12th सेंचुरी आती है, और 12th सेंचुरी में ये हमारे कर्नाटका में ये बहुत बड़े एक फिलोसोफर आते हैं, इनका नाम था बसवा, ओके। यहाँ पर एक ये न्यू सेक्ट स्टार्ट करते हैं जिसका नाम था वीरशैवा, और ये वीरशैवा बाद में बनता है लिंगायत। तो ये कर्नाटका के ये बहुत बड़े फिलोसोफर हैं। एक वर्ड और आपने इसमें देखा होगा, उस वर्ड का नाम था दसोहा, देखा था अभी आपने, एक बार बार रूल हिंदी दसोहा। तो दसोहा कुछ नहीं, आपको याद रखना है चैरिटी का ये वर्ड, एक चैरिटी के लिए होता है, अहम से मतलब इसमें निकला है, तो चैरिटी बोला जाता है दसोहा। चैरिटी और दसोहा में डिफरेंस क्या है वो मैं आपको बता देता हूँ। चैरिटी जो आप करते हैं कभी कभी उसमें आपके कुछ सेल्फ इंटरेस्ट होता है, ठीक है, कि आपने चैरिटी करनी है तो आपका कुछ इंटरेस्ट होगा, बट जब आप दसोहा वर्ड यूज करेंगे तो वो आप जो है एकदम बिल्कुल भी सेल्फिश नहीं होंगे उसमें, और जो आपका पर्पज होगा वो क्या होगा, दूसरे को सर्व करना होगा। तो चैरिटी कभी कभी ऐसा नहीं होता है, सर्व करने के पर्पज से नहीं होती है, ठीक है, अपने भी सेल्फ इंटरेस्ट होते हैं, बट जब दसोहा जब आप यूज करेंगे वर्ड तो उसमें क्या होगा आपका, याद रखिए, सर्व करने का। तो ये बाद में, जैसे मैंने आपको बताया, ये बाद में बन जाता है लिंगायत, ओके। तो ये बसव जो है बहुत फेमस होते हैं, और इनके ऊपर एक पूरा पुराण भी लिखा गया है जिसको हम बोलते हैं बसवा पुराण, क्लियर स्टूडेंट। तो 12th सेंचुरी के फिलोसोफर हैं, बाद में इनको कहीं ना कहीं हम देखते हैं कि इनको गॉड मान लिया गया है, कर्नाटका में गॉड माना जाता है, क्लियर।
सो लेट्स स्टार्ट डिसाइफरिंग व्हाट वी जस्ट हर्ड। अभी इसका जो ओवरऑल एनालिसिस है बजट का, दैट विल बी अपलोडिंग ऑन अपमीडिया डेफिनेटली, the upload will be in terms of the chapters of economy that you study. For example, there's growth and development, national income, monetary system, financial, like this. But there are certain inspiring themes within the budget. These themes, when they address, when the finance minister is talking about youth, let's say, or rural development, let's say. So they basically give you the pointers as to, in answer writing, what all dimensions you have to cover while providing sufficient information for that particular question. Okay? So if you talk about infrastructure, what all you have to cover? You talk about youth, what you have to cover? Like this. Yes? And especially, UPSC is asking questions like, what are the government initiatives in this regard? And what, according to you, should be done henceforth? Yes or no? So budget provides you the henceforth. Alright, and whatever government has been doing in that particular regard, at least the scheme base is provided there. Right? So, which they have discussed in the budget, so I was noting down particular area that they want to work on and what all scheme base they are trying to put in that particular segment. So, this helps us in understanding what is the convergence of a particular levels of schemes for a particular initiative that the government wants to take. Fine? And that way we have to also utilize the budget document. Otherwise, what we generally see is there are some 400 schemes going on in India, right? Out of all of them, around 86 schemes are there which the government effectively is working upon. These 86 schemes are categorized under different themes that we have. Okay, so accordingly, right now what we can do is categorization of those themes and any special terminology which has been coming in the budget schemes, right? Identification of the terminology will help you in the prelims because they directly ask what is dividend distribution tax, things like this, what is security transaction tax. They can be matched the following questions for this. In mains also, if you see last year 2018, there was a question on capital gains tax and dividend distribution tax. So these kind of questions always come, although taxation was one of the boring parts in this mains. Yeah, because they're referring to too many sections, too many figures, data is coming in. But eventually that's what UPSC is also looking for. When the others were not listening, were you listening? Okay, so let's break it down theme by theme. So overall they said there's a 10-point agenda or the vision within the budget. So of course we'll upload the 10-point agenda separately, right? But we're building up on the agenda one by one. So first agenda that the budget takes up is connectivity. Connectivity. Yes, for this basically the principle is reform, perform, transform. The principle is reform, perform and transform. And within connectivity, what they have said, what kind of schemes they wanting? See, the government has essentially focused on connectivity in few ways. One is physical, another is digital. Then there is governance or governmental. Yes, or institutional connectivity. And this theme in particular has been built throughout the budget. Yes, if you look at the physical dimension of connectivity, so they are focused upon roads. Yes or no? This is the first aspect. Or they are focused upon the physical infrastructure. If I want to standardize this, they are focused upon the physical infrastructure. So roads are one. In this, they are termed up Pradhan Mantri Grameen Sadak Yojana. They have talked about Bharat Mala. They have talked about Sagar Mala. Yeah, Jal Marg Vikas Yojana. So basically inland waterways and everything. Last year they declared all the inland waterways as national waterways. So that's what they are using for cargo movement also now, right? Okay, so if you move a little bit further, now within this they are also providing mobility solutions. One is infrastructure, second is the mobility aspect. So within mobility they got a scheme working, e-mobility. And to work for e-mobility, they have a particular scheme, FAME. Now the FAME was not a very successful scheme in phase 1 and 2 because most of the things that we were getting in FAME they were imported. Domestic production was very less and the taxation was also very high. Now they are moving on with the fame phase 3, third phase. So in the third phase of fame, now the government is basically looking at what? Tax reductions. Yeah, you are being given direct incentivization, basically. That is the phased aspect of this. It is direct incentives. So they said that when you buy an e-vehicle, you will get 2.5 lakh as direct tax benefits. Yes, while you're getting a loan for buying that particular vehicle. All right. Then there is one more thing in this. There's a national mobility card. It's also part of e-mobility. National mobility card. Another important aspect within your mobility solutions, right? So think of all this as the physical aspect for the movement of the people. All right, from one place to the another. If you talk about multidimensional poverty index these days, or the different committees which were coming after Suresh Tendulkar committee, the C. Rangarajan and the later Niti Aayog, they have discussed this mobilization or moving from one place to another, the mobility aspect, as one of the essential aspects for the human being. Yes, if they need to work somewhere or do something, mobility is important. So it must be covered in the daily expenditure allowances for you to calculate any kind of poverty. Isn't it? They did cater to this. So that's how the government is also working forward in that direction. Okay. So in any case of developmental agenda that they want to focus upon, even the first SDG goal, you know, requires no poverty. And the government can move towards no poverty through this mobilization solutions. In UPSC, they will create a curious case for you like this. You know, on one end, they will say, how is the infrastructure solution or how is the physical mobility solutions trying to remove poverty? Agar toh word infrastructure use hua toh phir bhi aapke liye asaan rahega. But agar unhone mobility seedha bol diya, toh phir aapke liye thoda mushkil ho jayega usko poverty se seedha connect karne mein. Theek? Toh aapne us time pe yehi baat karni hai ki zyadatar jitne bhi poverty ke upar committees ke recommendations aaye hain after Tendulkar, that is Rangarajan and Niti Aayog, then sab ne mobility ke upar dhyan diya. Right? So any e-mobility solution, anything that you're doing for this, maybe it's an infrastructure scheme, maybe anything, that is definitely helping in that issue as well. Definitely it's a movement forward with respect to economic growth, definitely. But it's also a part of poverty reduction. Okay. Then, as far as the digital connectivity is concerned, so in the rural, they mentioned about Bharat National Optical Fiber Network, you know, or the Bharat Net. So digital literacy, they are trying to root out through Bharat Net. Yes or no? That's what they mentioned in the rural part. Then, as far as the governance of institutional linkages are concerned, they are trying to create institutional linkages in all sectors and all aspects of economy. If you look at the new institutions that they are proposing, for example, Electronic Social Stock Exchange, isn't it? Electronic Social Stock Exchange. So they are really creating an institution of connectivity between the stock exchange and the people are also getting connected to the social leverage. See, there are investors within the social and they are basically utilizers of this social initiative. बहुत सारे लोग हैं जो social funding, philanthropy सब करते हैं, but इसका कोई organized तरीका नहीं होता। इसीलिए NGO, CSO इन सबको भी एक बार कभी-कभी शक की नजर से देखा जाता है। लेकिन अब इनके लिए एक systematic पहुंच शुरू हो गई है। That's another type of connectivity that the government is building between the investors, between those who have money and those who need to utilize that money for a particular developmental orientation, right? So maybe they are pro environment. Maybe they are pro-poor, maybe they are pro-disability, any kind of CSO that is working, that definitely needs to mobilize funds. Yes? So now they are connecting the investors and utilizers through electronic social stock exchange. This kind of institutions further also have been stated.
One nation, one grid.
One nation, one grid, definitely. Then, देयर इज अनदर वन, बताइए कौन कौन से नजर आए आपको?
नेशनल हाईवे ग्रिड,
नेशनल हाईवे ग्रिड. देन देयर इज जल शक्ति मंत्रालय, सो मेनी इंटीग्रेटेड मिनिस्ट्रीज. बेसिकली व्हाट आई मींस टू से इज दैट द गवर्नमेंट इज नाउ फोकसिंग अपॉन सम काइंड ऑफ कन्वर्जेंस. दिस इज जस्ट एन एग्जांपल ऑफ इट. Connectivity basically at the institutional level is moving towards further convergence. Noticing they're trying to bring the efforts which were firstly disaggregated in different directions into some common aspect. Correct? At least that much we can say. So this is also a movement when they combine the ministries and departments into one, that is convergence. When they create a particular aim for different categories of schemes under different themes, that's again convergence. Yes sir? If they say for youth, these are the 5 things that we are doing. Yes? For transportation or for rural, these are 10 things that we are doing. So that points towards the convergence. Otherwise, what used to happen before is, mostly for the political propaganda, a new scheme would be launched. Yes? One generally divorced from the purpose of the other. Now they are trying to build that convergence which was very essential otherwise. If you look at rural development in India, there is MNREGA. Heard of it? Now, MNREGA is basically unskilled workers. You are getting paid for 100 days of work. On the other end, you got Skill India Mission, Stand Up India Mission, and Startup India Mission, which is based upon either specific skills or entrepreneurial skills. So the clientele for these skill initiatives or skill enhancement initiatives is very much within the unskilled MNREGA workers. That's the people they need to skill. Yes or no? This is the convergence the government has finally started to look into now. If you see from the funding perspective, if you see from the institutional perspective. Isn't it? So let's see this convergence now in the rest of the themes. Okay? So themes within the budget. So beyond connectivity, next one that we can talk about is rural. Your favorite, rural. So for rural India, they said now 150th birth anniversary of Gandhi is going to come. So Antyodaya is again a philosophy in focus. Whenever something like this comes into focus, you must take care of it in the GS paper 4. Yes or no? Because one of the Antyodaya philosophy question can now emerge in the Gandhi. In your first chapter therein, ethics and human interface, yeah, or role of leaders, reformers and administrators, therein this philosophical attributes become important for the next year means. Okay, then they said we have the focus upon gaon, gareeb and kisan. So this is the ideology, focus ideology of the government, gaon, gareeb, kisan, right. Now within this, the schemes that they are trying to converge together are, first one, Ujjwala and Saubhagya. Yes or no? Both of them focus towards ease of living. Then the next thing that they are focused upon is Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Grameen. This is focused on housing for all. And in that they said there is speediness and sufficiency. These are the two things they are focusing on. Speediness in terms of 114 days, sufficiency in terms of 1.9 crore housing being created. Right? Then the third thing they are focusing upon is fishing. Because if you know, right now crops or cultivation from the field, that is basically 60 to 62% of farmers' income, right? The rest of the farmers' income in India is sourced from livestock, fisheries or aquaculture, right? And fisheries in particular, if I can go by the economic survey of last year, not this year, it was 8 to 9% contributing towards the farmers' income. Right? Even now it is 8 to 9%. It's not going to vary like this. Yes? So this way it is an important resource and now they have started focusing on it. And here they have got new scheme being launched, that is Pradhan Mantri Matsya Sampada Yojana. Okay. So it is a management framework and it addresses the gaps in value chain. These are the two things that you have to know about Pradhan Mantri Matsya Sampada Yojana. Just a management framework and a addressing gaps in the value chain. These are two things. Then, next she talked about this Pradhan Mantri Grameen Sadak Yojana. Yes? So here also they are focusing on what? Universal connectivity of eligible habitations. Now for prelims you must know what is this eligible habitation under PMGSY. Which habitation must be connected? So there is a population criteria, yes, and there is an infrastructure criteria, minimum. So only then you are eligible, and out of them 97% are covered. It is not 100%, because in pre they will try to invoke you like this. PMGSY has covered 100% habitations, has covered 97% habitation. Both statements are wrong, because they have not used the word eligible. Getting my point? So they'll work up something like this. PMGSY covers 100% habitations or 97% habitations. Both are wrong. Why? Eligibility. Okay. Then, as far as the sustainable development aspect is concerned, that is inbuilt into PMGSY, they said, because 35% of road construction material is now plastic in PMGSY. That is the technology augmentation. And they're trying to reduce the carbon footprint because of this. Right? Okay. Then, as far as rural is concerned, one more scheme they outlined is Sphurti. Yes, and in Sphurti, there is cluster-based development for traditional industries. And which are the three industries they focused upon?
Bamboo,
honey and khadi. These are the three industries which are focus groups therein. Okay, so for pre, you must know this. Aam taur pe pre ke aane tak ye sari information bol jaate hai. But इसको आप अभी से हाईलाइट करके साइड में रखोगे तो काम आएगी, ठीक है? Then, as far as another one scheme that is given is Aspire, yeah. So it is a business incubator essentially. What is a business incubator? Let's say you want to start a new business, so you go to these people, they'll tie you up. They'll tie you up with raw material providers, credit providers, market providers, any labeling certification providers, and then you are able to generate your business. You are easily able to work it out. So they are business incubators, and there are two kinds of business incubators she talked about. One is livelihood, other is technology. 80 livelihood and 20 technology business incubators she said that we are going to create, and this is basically for skilling the agri entrepreneurs. Yes? Okay. Then another one more principle or ideology they given is, why not Annadata becomes Urjadata? See, right now, even 1 or 2 months back, you've seen paddy stock being burned, yeah, wheat stock being burned. All this stocking burning basically is energy, right? Just that this energy is not perfectly utilized, or there is no value chain associated with this stock, which is left over after the collection of harvest. Yes? So basically that institutionalization of value chain is necessary. That's what she stated. Along with that, cattle feed, milk procurement and management of all these value chains associated with the farm can help in energy generation as well. So that is a dimension that you have to take care of. Then, another thing she talked about in agriculture, because when you talk of rural, you talk of agriculture, right? So that is, India is already self-sufficient in pulses. This was not the case even in 2018. This is only the case in this 2019 now. 2017-18 economic survey points that we are having the pulse imports of around 19 crore rupees. That was the pulses import. Year on year this varies, sometimes it is 30 crore rupees also. Because outside procurement of pulses is cheaper for India rather than producing within country. So this is the first year that this has been now achieved. Now we don't have to import pulses. But India is still very much dependent as far as oil seeds are concerned. Yes? Okay, moving forward. Then they talked about creation of 10,000 farmer producer organizations. You see, this is another one when I say it's an institutional linkage. So it's already there, they're trying to make more of them. What do FPOs basically do? They bring together the farmers and help them organize themselves and become entrepreneurs and directly sell their produce in the market so that they are generating the necessary profit. They don't route their products through the APMCs essentially, apart from the 23 mandated in the APMC Act. Okay, then next one, they said ENAM. So basically APMC Acts are essentially the state government initiatives, because agriculture is a state subject, right? So they've given something about electronic national agriculture market, for two purposes. One, ease of doing business and ease of living. वो कहते हैं सिर्फ बाकी लोगों के लिए नहीं है, फार्मर के लिए भी है. Essentially, ease of doing business has been essentially focused upon what aspect of Indian economy? Private sector, corporate sector, industry, but not agriculture. Now they want to inculcate this value of ease of doing business within the agriculture as well. Farmer, the business of farming itself is becoming difficult. Yes or no? There was a survey by an NGO, Lokniti. It stated that around 70% of farmers in India don't want their children to pick up any farming practices. And if they get a chance, they would like to join some job in the city rather than doing farming. Why should a farmer think like this? First reason is, there is marginal land holding in India. 1 acre, 60%. Less than 2 acres, 80%. Yes or no? So because of this marginal size of land holdings, agriculture by itself is not able to sustain the farmer or his family. So for him, he has to find his ease of doing business through livestock, fisheries, aquaculture, forestry, many other practices. Jugaad karne ke liye. Right? Right income ka jugaad karne ke liye. Abhi, the government wants them to sell their own produce, see what they can produce best, and cater to marketing practices. So you need a holistic framework. You know, just telling the farmer through DD Kisan or any kind of other initiatives ki aap wheat rice cycle se bahar nikal jaiye, kuch aur ugaiye. This is not sufficient. You need to ensure the full scale reform, that is as well as the backward and the forward linkages. The backward linkages here are being provided in the form of what? You see, unne kya bola abhi? Jo aspire programs hain jitne bhi hain, to business entrepreneurship wahan bhi build karenge. स्फूर्ति है तो वो भी वहाँ पे बिजनेस एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप बिल्ड करेंगे. किसान ही है जो थोड़ा बहुत ट्रेडिशनल क्राफ्ट भी कर रहा है, वही किसान है जो थोड़ा बहुत एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप भी कर रहा है. कोशिश उसकी यही है कि अपने लिए सफिशिएंट इनकम जनरेट कर ले. क्यों? क्योंकि एग्रीकल्चर के ऊपर कुछ खास भरोसा है नहीं. ठीक, तो इस तरह से होलिस्टिक डेवलपमेंट आपको चाहिए. और इन्हीं किसानों को साथ में ला के FPOs बना रहे हैं, इन्हीं किसानों को बोल रहे हैं कि आप अब ईनैम के थ्रू अपनी जो सेल्स हैं उनको आप प्रमोट कीजिए. That's how it is moving forward. Okay. Another one they have now talked about is cutting the cost, that is ZBNF, Zero Budget Natural Farming. This is basically you conserving the seeds, the pesticide, everything from the field and trying to utilize that. Nothing is to be purchased from the market as inputs. So this is working at the back end. Jisme keh rahe the ki backward or forward, dono linkages sudharna padega. So ZBNF works at the backward linkages. ENAM, FPO works in the forward linkages. Okay. Then there is Jal Shakti Mantralaya, because irrigation is essential for agriculture. So now they have converged all the institutions that were working separately for irrigation purposes or water management as it is. So for holistic water management in India, you created this Jal Shakti Mantralaya. Otherwise, what is happening? See, rivers, etc. is under which schedule? Center. Irrigation is under state. Does it make sense? Can you irrigate without rivers? No. Essentially, this is the problem. So anytime there is management of rivers, anytime management of water bodies, that is generally state's business. As far as the irrigation is concerned. But anytime there is allocation of rights with respect to rivers, that is center's business. So now they created a singular framework. And within that comprehensive framework, things can be addressed now. See, for example, there is SYL dispute between Punjab and Haryana. There are, you know, Kaveri water dispute, Krishna water dispute between various states as the uphill and downstream states are connected. So between various states, always with respect to water distribution, there are big problems. Because harmonization of policy was not happening to deal with this. Now this new ministry will be able to handle the harmonization of policy. Yes or no? Okay. Now moving forward. So they said there's a Jal Jeevan Mission that we are going to create. This also is focusing upon convergence only. For what purposes? Sustainable water supply across the country. So convergence is an inbuilt theme throughout the budget. You can see it like this. Yes? Okay. Next one they said there's a Jal Shakti Abhiyan. And they are trying to work on Jal Shakti Abhiyan, especially on the 1592 over-exploited blocks for which they will be taking up the funds from CAMPA. The funds which are given for CAMPA, they will be using it for the efficient and sustainable water management under Jal Shakti Abhiyan. Okay. All this recalls with respect to the integrated water management. Heard of this? Integrated water management? This is a long time aspect which Planning Commission once stated. Integrated pest management, integrated water management, integrated so many other things with respect to the agriculture. Right? So here, integrated water management is actually starting to take shape, which was once given by Planning Commission somewhere in the 10th five-year plan. Alright? So this is the theme now coming into action after too long. Next thing they talked about in rural is Swachhta. Yeah? So open defecation free declaration is one thing and open defecation free practice is something else. In budget they are talking about declaration. Yes? How many villages have declared themselves as open defecation free? So most of them will declare, but still it is happening sometimes, which is noticed. So we cannot go on the budget figures really, but anyhow 5.6 lakh villages they said have declared themselves as ODF and 9.6 crore toilets have been created. Now there is next one, to undertake solid waste management will be the next step for the Swachh Bharat mission. See, the solid waste management rules were notified in 2018. Now the Swachh Bharat mission modality or the organization structure will take care of solid waste management. So the nodal in charge at the district level, at the subdivisional level, these people will be taking care of the solid waste management as well, how it is being actually put into practice, right? So this we have to take note of, especially for the means, not for the free. Then there is Pradhan Mantri Grameen Digital Sakshata Abhiyan. This is for the digital literacy of the rural. Again, connectivity and convergence, right? So all these are the rural themes which are posted. Now when you study these themes, they are not limited to economy. Yes, they are interdisciplinary in nature. So rural development for you, whether given through budget, whether given through any Niti Aayog document, has to be interdisciplinary study. You must take up your resources from human geography, you must utilize economy, you must utilize polity, and you must utilize what else? Social issues. Yes or no? So in this way, question for this particular thing can be there in GS1, GS2, GS3, maybe even ethics. Antyodaya as a philosophical aspect. Get my point? So like this you have to prepare. So whenever something like budget comes in, what it essentially provides you is how a government sees things. When the government is looking at rural, what is it really projecting? Yes? That's how you have to understand things. Similarly, if Niti Aayog is putting up any document like a 3-year annual action agenda or anything, what you have to really understand is what is the structure of government's thought. That's how you have to understand it. Appraise it that way. And then utilize it for your means. Because otherwise, you will be focused at it partially. Aap ratta maroge, wo kahin kaam nahi aana. Sirf isko holistic framework mein dekho ki jab government rural ki baat karti hai, to kis direction mein gayi? Theek? So, wo swachhta ki direction mein gayi, wo irrigation ki direction mein gayi, connectivity ki direction mein gaya, aur skill development ki direction mein gaya, digitization ki direction mein gaya. This is how the government is focused upon rural development. So through the schemes, don't just look at the scheme as it is. Look at the directions through which the government is focused upon rural these days. So anytime they give you a question, what are the initiatives taken by the government of India for rural development? Yes? Write a question. What are the initiatives taken by government of India for rural development? Give suggestions upon betterment in this regard. Or they'll ask you what according to you should be done for better rural development. Or sometimes they'll just say critically examine. The meaning is same. Yes or no? So just point the scheme, tell what the problems are, how is it actually working, tell how is it holistic or not so holistic. What is that the government is missing right now? Can you see at that? Can you look? Abhi jo 8-9 aapne perspective note kiye hain rural development ke andar, गवर्नमेंट कौन सी पोजीशन पे मिस आउट कर रहा है रूरल के अंदर? एजुकेशन की कोई बात नहीं, हालांकि एजुकेशन की बात हुई लेकिन
रूरल पर्सपेक्टिव
हायर लेवल पे कोई रूरल पर्सपेक्टिव से स्पेसिफिक इंटरवेंशन नहीं आया। हेल्थ की कोई बात नहीं स्पेसिफिकली,
पॉलिटिकल
जो पुराना चला आ रहा है वही चला, ठीक। हेल्थ के ऊपर तो उन्होंने आशा या एनआरएचएम तक का नाम तक नहीं लिया, नेशनल रूरल हेल्थ मिशन और नेशनल हेल्थ मिशन एज इट इज कॉल्ड नाउ। यस, नो स्पेसिफिक फोकस वाज गिवन। व्हाट एल्स? पंचायती राज इंस्टीट्यूशन, वेरी गुड। सो गवर्नेंस इंटरवेंशन दैट इज बॉटम अप वे ऑफ वर्किंग और डिसेंट्रलाइजेशन वाज नॉट टॉक्ड अबाउट। यस नो? देन स्पेसिफिक रोल ऑफ ग्राम सभा वाज नेवर टॉक्ड अबाउट। Social audits were not highlighted. Are you understanding? So whenever they are talking about these things in any document, in any speech, they are talking about it politically. So sometimes you get a question in GS paper 2, budget is a political document. Examine. So only to forward the agenda of government of the day, they'll provide you with a document. Yes? That only highlights the present day government's agenda, that's all. And highlighting of this present day government agenda is because politics is essentially deciding who gets what, when and where. That's all. It's a decision making exercise. So they're deciding who gets what, when and where, and within this decision they have allocated something to somebody, something to somebody, as per their convenience and comfort. So it is not holistic, it is still partial. Getting my point? So always you should, as an administrator, think about the holisticness or the comprehensive. Have they dealt with this or this or this or not? Like this. Don't take budget as the final argument. Don't take Niti Aayog as a final argument. Always have your knowledge intact. Jitne bhi subjects mein aapne jo bhi padha hai. Samajh aaya? To ye baat to karenge budget ke andar, lekin kuch hi pehlu pe baat karenge. To jab aapko question UPSC puchta hai, critically examine. तो क्या बताना है कि ये पहलू तो छोड़ दिए, दे आर इग्नोर्ड पार्ट्स, लीस्ट अटेंशन हैज बीन गिवन ऑन दिस एस्पेक्ट्स। अब इसको आप कैसे प्रेजेंट करते हो आंसर राइटिंग में, ये मैटर करेगा कि दे हैव फोकस्ड अपॉन द फंक्शनल बट नॉट द स्ट्रक्चरल, इस तरह से दे हैव फोकस्ड अपॉन द आइडियोलॉजिकल बट नॉट द फिनोमेनोलॉजिकल। ये आपकी वर्डिंग है, कैसे आपने उसको वर्कआउट करना है। गॉट द आइडिया? ठीक, let's take up one more and then we'll conclude it. The rest I'll provide you within the document. Yes, and one more thing before we end this discussion. Jo economic survey kal aaya, iske upar we'll be having 5 classes on economic survey. My plan to have those 5 classes is next to next week, not this Monday to Friday, next Monday to Friday. Yes, the timings of those classes will be given to you in the message and I'll put it on the notice board as well. Will be 5-day classes. Will be covering both volume 1 and volume 2. But the coverage is not supposed to be exhaustive. Means we'll not be reading out economic survey. That's your job. What we'll be doing is creating structures for answer writing out of economic survey. And whatever is to be observed from prelims point of view within economic survey. That's our job. Right? The first job will be whatever issues has been highlighted from the mains point of view in the economic survey, we have to work on that, right? And you must read the economic survey thoroughly. Don't go for any second-hand copies online because they will not make sense to you otherwise. Start from chapter 1, go till chapter last. Invest time because now is the time that you will be building your capability for next year pre or mains. And even if you are building your capability for this year pre or mains, at least identify the issues that they have talked about, at least identify the data, how they are giving it. That's our job right now with respect to economics, sir. And that we will do in the Monday to Friday session in next week. Okay? So probably after 15th? Yeah, probably after 15th. Okay, so moving on, urban. So last one that is we are going to take up right now. So in urban they say rapid urbanization is an opportunity or a challenge? It's an opportunity. Now right now, the pace of urbanization has been kind of arrested. Or is it fast increasing? Government says rapid urbanization, but is it fast increasing? 67% is rural, 33% is urban right now. And these are the figures we are listening to since 2011. Yes or no? Back in the day we used to say 70% is rural, 30% is urban. So only 3% urbanization has happened over almost 8 to 9 years. So it's not that rapid. Now what is arresting the pace of urbanization? That's also a question then. Yes? There must be some challenge. Although government always sees or projects this as an opportunity, but there has to be a challenge. Why there's a so slow pace in urbanization? And even if it has happened, you just go outside Chandigarh, look at the periphery, how the urbanization is happening. It's very slow. The buildings are there, they're half-baked cakes, you know, standing. Nothing is happening there. For the last 5 years, I'm looking at this OMAX in this direction, and Zirakpur in this direction, and Greater Mohali Airport Authority and everything that is coming up in that direction. And if you go this way, Nayagaon and everything. Last 5 to 10 years, they are stagnated. Because urbanization is a part of infrastructure, you know, development also. And infrastructure industry as it is, has been going into tumultuous since 2010-11. Know this. The reason for that is a greater NPA crisis. The projects have been on hold. Investments are not coming in. So most of the infrastructure projects are actually stopped or stagnated, moving at a very slow pace. And if the infrastructure is not moving, how is urbanization moving? Definitely there is bound to be some chaos. One of the chaos is, you see it on Chandigarh road every day, traffic. Don't you? When I came to this city as a student in 2002, hardly there was traffic. Now if you move out, you have to think about traffic. Yes or no? This is what? This is infrastructure not getting sufficient amount of investments. If flyover was to be constructed in between the Tribune Chowk area and the Zirakpur area, yes, still that flyover is nowhere to be seen. Only ground level research is going on for last 25 years. Not last 2 years, 25 years. They are always announcing, this is the arrested pace of urbanization. This is the city beautiful that we are talking about. If you go out of this, you go to Ludhiana, Amritsar, anywhere. Yeah, or your cities where you come from in the ground reality. That is totally different. Maximum that has happened is what? Sanitation has improved a bit. Yes? Maybe the internal streets have been made now pakka. They used to be kacha streets. Yes, within the towns and cities and everywhere. Yes, maximum this much has happened. We don't have still 24/7 water, 24/7 electricity, which are the basic necessities if you want to call something as urban. Okay, anyhow, now moving forward. What are the schemes that they're proposing? So they say Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana, urban. Remember smart city? No mention of smart city in budget. Why so? Think about it. No mention of Amrut in budget. Atal Mission for Rejuvenation of Urban Transportation, right? No mention at all. Why so?
Populace.
Because ye chalan. Jisko smart city bola bhi gaya, jiske upar paise bhi kharch kiye gaye itne der se. Uske upar koi results to aaya nahi. Chandigarh is one of the smart cities. What happened? Where do you see the smartness? Yes or no? As an outcome, nothing has come, so they are not even talking about it now in the budget. Anyhow, what they talked about, let's talk about that. So they say, we are going to create a Gandhipedia. Wikipedia kafi nahi tha kya, aur bhi dekhna padega. Then Swachh Bharat Mission has covered already 95% of cities in India, and they have declared themselves as ODF, open defecation free. Two things she talked about, urban. Anytime you want to understand anything about urban, read Ishar Judge Aluwalia. I-S-H-E-R, Ishar Judge Aluwalia. So she is the lady with the best articles on urban management or urbanization. Or read a Yojana magazine on urbanization. That's a better way to look at it holistically. The government is only partially talking about urban management. And if you look at India, I think these two should suffice. should look at India as rural development and you should look at India as urban development. That's all. Where else do you find India? But they have anyway categorized India into many other things. They have talked about youth. Yes? So for them, maybe youth lives somewhere else. It's not a part of rural or urban. Yes? So they've given multiple schemes with respect to youth, you know. They say new national education policy will be there. We are trying to create a national education policy since we got independence. Remember, even Gandhi gave Nayi Taleem. Yeah? Then you created UGC and you're trying to create a national education policy. Only problem with national education policy is consensus. What we should study and what we should not study. And you know, it's not majorly policy driven from what we should study or what we should not study. It is also policy driven from the angle of who should teach and how they should teach. What should be the qualities of the teacher? At least that much we have to focus on. Look at what Punjab Technological University and PTU kind of things have done to education. Massification essentially is not a good thing in terms of education. Qualitativeness is the good thing. You create 1 lakh graduates which cannot find any employment, which cannot find any good pay for their work. What you are creating is a disgruntled youth. Yes or no? Who are now educated and unemployed. If they were uneducated and unemployed, we can at least justify padhani hai. Hai na? But when the system is charging a fee, giving you a degree, and you're not able to find the worth for that degree or yourself, what is the use of such an education? That's the big question mark. So that's where the government has to think about. So they are talking about, you know, Gyan, global initiative for academic networking. Yeah? And they're talking about imprint, they're talking about study in India program, and the bahar se log aayenge aur yahan padhenge. Punjab mein to reverse chal raha hai. Australia, Canada and everywhere. Now people will come and study here. Unka bhi bhavishya khatre mein dal do. Apna sahi. This basically depicts that you are now overtaken by your ideology. And this ideology is what? I am the best. Yes? This ideology should not come in government infrastructure. That I am the best. Government infrastructure has to think about adopting best practices and innovating next practices. Whatever are the best practices going on elsewhere, you should be able to adopt them friendlily, saying, okay, this is good, let's see. Let's do it this way. Right now, most of the innovation is happening in America. Yes or no? So, if based upon your knowledge you are able to innovate, that means you had a good knowledge, a good education base. The second best is happening in China. Yes, they have the maximum number of patents after USA. India is nowhere. India is maybe 17th, 18th in this list, in the number of patents which we have gone for. So innovation is not happening, means most of the learning that we are doing is rote learning. Yes or no? Cramming things. So based on cramming things, you cannot create new things. Because what you are interested in replication, not in creation. Yes? So your market is always just replicating trends. But that's how Indian market works. Parliamentary democracy, replication of British. That's how Indian constitution works. But this should not be the constitution of Indian future. Anytime the future developmental discourse has to work on, should not be new education policy, it should be improved education policy. We already have one in place, just try and improve it. Because if you bring in something new, which is very much ideologically driven, we cannot expect it to take us further than what it has already done for us. Yes? So this kind of ideological dilemma should not be there. Then there's talking about creation of National Sports Education Board. Yeah, for development of sportsperson and everything. Fine, good thing. But how many is the medal tally right now in the Olympics? Where do we stand there? Very poorly. Yes, sir? So performance should come with sports. I'm not saying there should be performance pressure on the sportsmen. That's not the thing. But there should be at least institutional pressure on the government. If you're creating a policy like Khelo India scheme and everything, how many have you been able to make play? कितने स्पोक्सपर्संस आपने क्रिएट किए, एटलीस्ट इसका डेटा दो. दिस हाउ यू हैव टू जज देम अल्टीमेटली. सो विल बी अपलोडिंग ऑन अभिपीडिया इन द फ्री रिसोर्सेज सेक्शन विदिन वन और टू डेज मैक्सिमम बाय संडे. दैट मच टाइम आई विल टेक टू एनालाइज द बजट एज पर योर सिलेबस and I'll upload that there, so download it from there. Message will definitely come to all of you as soon as that happens. All right, so thank you for participating in the budget session.